Welcome back to the channel, everybody. It's Myles. Now I'm going to give my thoughts on the UFC 254 main event, Khabib Nurmagomedov versus Justin Gaethje. I'm going to give my thoughts on the fight, what I thought was going to happen compared to what did happen. And I'm also going to talk about what's next in the UFC's lightweight division, since Khabib is retiring and going to move on and not fight anymore. Mama said that she doesn't want him to fight because his father's not around anymore, and he's going to keep that promise to his mom. He said, "Mama, I'm going to do this one fight with Justin, and after that, I'm done. I'm not going to fight anymore because father's not here." And Khabib also said, "Hey, if I said it, then I'm going to own up to it." So that's it. Khabib's done. 29-0. Retiring from the sport of mixed martial arts. Never going to fight again. Now, going into this fight with Justin Gaethje, I knew on paper that Khabib should go out there, take him down, choke him out. But I bet against Khabib. I thought that Justin Gaethje was going to go out there, weather that takedown, stay sticking, moving, catch him with some big punches, chop that leg, and hey, it was close to happen. It was close to happen, but in this game, it doesn't matter how close you are. At the end of the day, it matters who wins. And even though Justin had some good moments in the fight, he still ended up getting caught in that triangle choke and getting submitted and choked out. So at this moment right now, from my last predictions video, I am basking in defeat. What can I say? I went against Khabib and he proved me wrong. He really did. So I'll leave a second right now for anybody that wants to drop a comment and say, "I told you so. That Khabib was going to choke him out. Delete that video now." I'll give you a second. Go ahead. Drop it in there. Throw your jabs. Throw your punches at me. And hey, while you're at it, why don't you just smash that thumbs up button and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Now, leading into this fight with Justin Gaethje, there was some unknowns. You know, Justin did have some great wrestling on paper, some great defensive wrestling at that. And then on top of that, Khabib's father just passed away, so I didn't know which Khabib was going to show up. If he was going to be hesitant, if he was going to be kind of second-guessing himself. And so leading into this fight, that was some of the unknowns. The fight started off just like any other fight does. When Justin and Khabib came out, they both were sitting there kind of staring at each other, trying to get a feel for the other opponent. Now, as they started moving around, you could tell Justin was staying low, keeping his hands low, waiting for that takedown, which obviously makes sense because you watch all of Khabib's last fights, he starts rushing, he starts getting people to the ground, and that's where he does his best work. Now, once they started feeling each other out, Khabib was kind of a little hesitant. He was more kind of patiently waiting and kind of looking like he was going to pick his shots a little more. Now, once Justin came out there, landed a big overhand right, and started throwing some big bombs, you could tell that Khabib really didn't like that. So he automatically went to what his game plan was going to be, and he got there a lot faster. Let's get him tired. You could tell that was his automatic response. Let's get him tired. And he started using it. Khabib started picking up the pace and literally just chasing Justin down. Changing levels, chasing him down, throwing a big hook, a big jumping knee. Basically just throwing output at Justin because he wanted to get Justin worn down. Whether it was going to be from takedowns or strikes, getting him moving around a lot, which was beautiful by Khabib because Justin does really good when he's stationary, but Khabib made him run around the cage by moving, the like fearing of that takedown. And that's what it was. Justin had some good moments. He landed a couple of good leg kicks, man. I was there and I was like, man, I called it. I felt like he was going to chop down Khabib's leg and he was doing a good job. But at the end of that first round, Khabib ended up getting him down, getting him to the mat, and ended up going straight to full mount with like 30 seconds left. And I was like, oh man, oh, like that's not good. You know, I expected a little bit more from Justin on the ground, getting back up, maybe getting to all fours, but maybe he was nervous of the rear naked choke, or maybe just Khabib's strength and position was just that good that he really couldn't move. So the first round ended with Justin basically just in mount and surviving. Now the second round was just a little bit like the first, basically. Justin came out looking to land some of them big hooks, some big punches, which he was close. He did crack him a little bit. He landed a couple more leg kicks. And in between the rounds, you could hear Trevor Whitman telling Justin, hey, a couple more of those leg kicks, man. He's not going to be walking really good. And that was what Justin was trying to do. But in the end, Khabib shot in. Justin did a good sprawl. Khabib took his back, cut the corner, put both hooks in. And Justin basically couldn't do much there. Justin rolled to his back. Now from here, I didn't expect this. I've never seen Khabib roll for a triangle or go for a submission and basically put himself in harm's danger by going to his own back. But that's what Khabib did. He was on top, pushed the arm under, stepped over for the triangle, wrapped it up, sat back, and had Justin's arm extended so it looked like almost an arm bar. And then from there, he transitioned. He just squeezed onto that triangle choke. Justin ended up tapping, but the referee didn't see it, so Khabib held on for a little bit longer until Justin's arm was limp. Referee grabbed it. Boom, he was out. And the referee pulled Khabib off, stood him up, and Khabib is victorious. 29-0, retains that lightweight world championship, and then the moment came. He's going to retire. Now, I personally thought that Khabib was going to do at least one more fight because I read in interviews and he said that he wanted to get to 30-0. But after that impressive performance and after beating Dustin Poirier, Conor McGregor, and now Justin Gaethje, he did have a commitment to his mother. You know, his father passing away, his mom didn't want him to fight, and he's going to uphold that promise that he set to his mom, and that's very, very respectful. And on top of that, Khabib's career, man, has been one of the best ever. I wouldn't say he's necessarily the GOAT because you have guys like John Jones and Anderson Silva, but he's up there with those guys. And the way he presents himself, the way he goes out, he stays humble, he stays a man of faith, he goes out there, he mauls people, he gets them down. What's special about Khabib is that you know what he's going to do. Not a lot of times do you know exactly what a fighter is going to do, but with him, you know what he's going to do, and you still cannot stop it. Or at least the 29 opponents that he's went up against could not stop it. And it has been a pleasure watching him compete in the octagon, bringing back that true essence of grappling and wrestling, something that we don't see enough nowadays. So my hat's off to Khabib on a great career. Now with him retiring, that opens up the floodgates for other contenders in this division, this 155-pound lightweight division, which is stacked from top to bottom. You have guys like Conor McGregor, Dustin Poirier, you have Tony Ferguson, you have Dan Hooker, and now you have Michael Chandler. These are all guys that on any given day can win that strap. And it's wide open right now. I mean, what a time to be in the lightweight division. You have Khabib stepping away, and now it's like a sprint for that title. Who wants it? Who's going to get it? Now, my thoughts are on this. I would like to see Conor McGregor and Dustin Poirier fight. They're already scheduled to fight early January or end of January. And the winner of that, I think, should be one of the have open slots to fight for the belt. Now, the other matchup I would like to see is Tony Ferguson versus Michael Chandler. Now, I know a lot of people are probably commenting right now, Michael doesn't deserve it. What's Chandler done? Tony would smash him, all that stuff. But I realistically would like to see this fight. I think it's a great stylistic matchup. I wonder if Tony can keep it on the feet and pick Chandler apart, or if Chandler is going to land some big punches and take him down. Now, the winner of this Tony Ferguson versus Michael Chandler fight, I believe should be in the other slot to fight for that world title. Now, on paper, all these fights stylistically are awesome. I mean, you have Dustin Poirier, who obviously can bang, can wrestle, he's got the heart of a champion. You have Conor McGregor, who, I mean, he's one of the most recognized fighters or athletes in the world today. So, you know, he's charismatic, you know, he's got great striking. He comes, he brings it, heavy pressure, very precise. You have Michael Chandler, who has a conditioning to go for days, power in both hands, Division I All-American Wrestling. Tony Ferguson, man, come on. This guy comes out, he'll break you down with kicks, knees, punches, elbows, everything. He can submit you off of his back. He can land stuff from standing up or on the ground. And he's tough, tough, tough. That fight that Tony had with Justin Gaethje just shows how much damage he can take and still keep pushing forward. I mean, this man will literally fight until the death. And let's not forget about Justin. I mean, Justin Gaethje, it's tough to say he should fight for a title right now just because he's kind of coming off of a loss, even though it's to one of the best to ever do it, Khabib. But I wouldn't be surprised if they throw him in there for a title shot, depending on what's going on with the sickness that's going on, people getting, you know, hurt, falling out, people getting sick, not being able to fight. So we might see Justin get thrown into the mix as well. But I feel like right now, those four guys, Tony, Dustin, Conor, and Michael Chandler, I feel like they're the ones right now that are kind of right in that front line for that title shot. Either way, it's a stacked division. All these fighters are super exciting, and we're going to see who's going to be the next superstar of the lightweight division. Khabib time's over now. He's retired. He's moving on. And let's see. Maybe it'll be Tony Ferguson time. Maybe it'll be Michael Chandler time. I don't know, but we'll be talking about it a lot on this channel. So thank you for sticking with me this whole video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys next time.